Hello everyone, now we have to discuss the concept of parallel resonance. So if you know the concept of series resonance, means if you have clear cut concept of series resonance, this concept of parallel resonance is very 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 easy. Okay.
Parallel
resonance, okay. So what is the circuit diagram for this? We will consider parallel RLC circuit. We have R, we have L, and we have what? C, right? C, L, R, this is the current source. Here the reference is what? Voltage, right? Let us say this is voltage. Okay, this is the parallel resonant circuit. So in this, what we have? Admittance, right? There series resonant circuit we have impedance, here we have admittance. Y is equals to what? 1 by R plus J into here omega C minus 1 by omega L, right? This is the overall admittance from this parallel RLC circuit, we all know that. So from this Y is equals to, can we write 1 by R is nothing but what? Z plus J, this is what? Capacitive susceptance minus inductive susceptance, right? 1 by XC is nothing but capacitive susceptance, 1 by XL is nothing but inductive, sorry, this is inductive susceptance. Therefore, we all know that under resonance, what is happening? Imaginary part of Y should be is equals to 0, whether it is series RLC circuit or parallel RLC circuit, under resonance the total imaginary part should be equals to 0, right? There we have X, net reactance is equals to 0, that is imaginary part of that series RLC circuit. Like that, here also net susceptance is equals to 0, that is net susceptance which is equals to 0, means what? B, which is equals to capacitive susceptance minus inductive susceptance is equals to 0. Therefore, PC is equals to BL, right? Same concept of series resonance, that is here. There we have what? XC is equals to XL. Here we have what? Capacitive susceptance is equals to inductive susceptance. So BC is nothing but what? Omega C, right? That is 1 by XC is nothing but omega C minus 1 by omega, which is equals to 0. So from this, omega C is equals to omega L. Therefore, now we have to write omega R square is equals to 1 by LC. There we have, is there any change in the resonant frequency? If you consider series RLC circuit or parallel RLC circuit, there is no change in the resonant frequency. It is 1 by root LC radians per second or 1 by 2 pi root LC hertz, right? That's it. So we have derived the resonant frequency. Then what we have observed now, that is variation of circuit parameters, variation of circuit parameters, variation of circuit parameters with frequency, that's it. What is the first one? That is G versus frequency. G means what? 1 by R. That is G is equal to conductance is nothing but 1 by R, right? Then what is the graph? We all know that Y is equals to वन बाई आर होल स्केयर प्लस जे इंटू ओमेगा सी माइनस ओमेगा एल होल स्केयर, राइट, विच इज ऑलवेज मोर देन वन बाई आर, राइट. सेम लाइक द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ सीरीज रेजोनेंस, देयर वी हैव व्हाट, स्केयर रूट ऑफ आर स्केयर प्लस एक्स स्केयर विच इज मोर देन द वैल्यू ऑफ आर, हियर रेसिप्रोकल ऑफ आर, दैट्स इट, विच इज ऑलवेज मोर देन वन बाई आर. देयर फोर y is equals to 1 by r, which is nothing but what? Z, which is minimum, right? Which is minimum. There impedance is minimum, here admittance is minimum. Therefore, what about impedance in this case of parallel RLC? It is maximum, that is reciprocal of admittance. There admittance is maximum, reciprocal of impedance. Impedance is minimum there, that is admittance is maximum there. Like that, here we have minimum admittance and maximum impedance. Therefore, what is the graph? This is the frequency, this is 1 by r, right? Obviously, this is the constant value. Minimum, that too constant, independent of frequency. Conductance is the independent of frequency, right? This is what, 1 by r, that's it, this is 1 by r. Next, G completed. Second one, net susceptance versus frequency, that is net susceptance is what? B net is equals to B, right? Where B C is equals to what? 1 by X C, that is omega C, and B L is what? 1 by omega L, right? So, we have what? This is omega, this is B, right, mod of B. So, first we have to write, we have to draw B C, that is omega C, that is always constant, right. This is omega C, there we have what, X L, omega L is equal to X L, it is always directly proportional with frequency, like that omega C, B C, right. This is, what about 1 by omega L? This is what? 1 by omega L. So, minus 1 by omega L is nothing but what? Like that we will get, right? Then tell me, this point is nothing but what? Resonant frequency. So, then what is this region? What is this region? So, in this region always omega less than omega r, omega more than omega r. Then tell me, so what is this region? Is it lagging region or leading region? Like that, is it lagging region or leading region? See, here in between this 0 to and up to omega r, which value is more? See, here we have what, 1 by omega l is more than omega c, that is 1 by omega l is more than omega c, right? Here 1 by omega L is less than omega C in this region, right. But coming to this region, 1 by omega L is equals to omega C only. We have three regions, right? This part and this part. This is the point under resonance. 1 by omega L more than omega C, 1 by omega L is equal to omega C, that is why we have resonance, 1 by omega L less than omega C, clear? 1 by omega L is nothing but what? Inductive susceptance more than capacitive susceptance, here inductive susceptance less than capacitive susceptance, here inductive susceptance is equal to capacitive susceptance. Therefore, tell me, inductive susceptance is more than capacitive susceptance, therefore This is the region we have lagging power factor. In this we have what? UPF. Always under resonance the power factor is what? UPF. This is leading region. Clear? This is lagging. This is UPF. This is leading. There we have what? Leading, UPF, lagging. That's opposite to the top. That's it. This is the conductance and net susceptance. Next we have to get admittance. Next, third one, admittance versus frequency, right? That is V is equals to, Y, not V, 1 by R whole square plus omega C minus omega L whole square, which is more than 1 by R, right? It is more than 1 by R. Under resonance, Y is equals to 1 by R only, right? Which is what? Minimum. Therefore, we have omega, we have mod Y, then tell me, when omega is equals to 0, what is the value of Y? What is the value of Y? Infinite, or you can write. Omega is equals to 0, omega is equals to omega r, omega is equals to infinite. Y is equals to what? Infinite. At this situation, when omega is equals to omega r, obviously Y is equals to what? 1 by r. At this situation, Y is equals to infinite. That's it, right? Which is minimum, same like in the case of series resonance. This is mod Y, this is frequency. You can get like this, okay? This is the minimum value, that is omega r. Right, this is 1 by r, this is the region 1 by r, right? This is the graph for admittance. Next, fourth one, current versus frequency. Then tell me, how we can get the value of current? We know that Y is equals to 1 by r, which is minimum value. Therefore, what about admittance, which is equals to 1 by reciprocal, which is maximum? If impedance is maximum, what about current? V by Z. This is maximum, the current is minimum, right? Current is minimum. So, in parallel resonance, we have minimum value of current. This is I. Same like in the case of admittance we got. This is the value of current. That is minimum at what? Resonant frequency, maximum other than resonant frequency. So, we have completed G, net susceptance, admittance, and current. Next, yeah, we forgot to draw phase angle versus frequency in case of series resonance. Now we have to do that. That is phase angle versus, okay. What is the phase angle in series resonance? Phi is equal to tan inverse omega L minus omega C by R, right? This is series resonance. Like that, what is the phase angle in case of parallel resonance? Just we have omega C minus 1 by omega L by 1 by R. That's it. This is for parallel resonance. Then when omega is equals to 0, what is the angle? When omega is equals to infinite, what is the angle? When omega is equals to 0, this is what? Infinite. Infinite means what? Minus 90 degrees. If it is infinite, it is 90 degrees. If you consider any case, this case or this case, you will get the phase angle. When omega is equal to 0, phi in minus 90. When omega is equal to infinite, phi is equal to 90. Whether it is series or parallel. Then, this is the frequency. This is minus 90. This is plus 90. This is phi. Right? Versus frequency. We got like this. We got like this. Okay? That's it. So, in case of series, this is leading, this is UPF, this is lagging, this is series, right? This set is nothing but series resonance. In case of parallel resonance, this is what? Lagging. This is what? UPF. This is leading. That's it. This set is for what? Parallel. Graph is same, but the power factor is different. So, the frequency which is less than omega r under series resonance is what? Leading. In case of parallel, that is lagging. But the frequency which is more than resonant frequency in series resonance is what? Lagging power factor. In case of parallel, that is leading power factor. That's it. Next, we have to see the phasor diagram. That is case 3 phasor diagram, right? You all know that. What is the reference in the parallel circuits? Voltage, right? So, which is the phasor which is in phase with voltage? Obviously, that is the current through what? Resistor IR, clear. Then what about IL and IC? IL always lags voltage by some angle, like that IC leads voltage by some angle. Therefore, this is what IC, the phase angle between this IC and V is nothing but 90 degrees, right? This is what IL, right? Satisfied. IL lags V by 90 degrees, IC leads V by 90 degrees, clear. So, this is what? Both are equal. Therefore, IR is equals to what? Then what is the resultant? IR is equals to IS. That is, IS should be equals to IR. Mod of IS is equals to mod of IR. That is, phase angle is what? 0 degrees. Power factor is nothing but UPF. Means the total current supplied to the resistive part only. Why not for L and C? We are dealing with steady state analysis. That is why the total current is dealing with what? Resistive part. This is the phasor diagram for this parallel RLC circuit. Clear? Next. Have completed basic part, variation of circuit parameters. Next, Q factor. Right? So, what is Q factor? 2 pi into peak energy stored by energy dissipated in one cycle. Clear? We have discussed RLC, then we will discuss parallel RC first. Okay. Then this is R, this is C. So, Q factor, which is nothing but 2 pi into peak energy stored, that is half C V square, right? C, peak energy V m whole square. Energy dissipated in 1 second means what? V square by R into T. Why we are considering here V? Because we are dealing with parallel circuits, that's why voltage is taken as reference. Therefore, Vrms by square, this is the power into T, right? So, from this Q factor, which is equals to 2 pi by T into half, this should be written as Vm by root 2 whole square by Vrms square by R, that's it. So, Vrms square, this one gets cancelled. So, from this Q factor, which is nothing but 2 pi by T is nothing but what? Omega C by 1 by R, we have like this, right? So, parallel RC circuit, the Q factor is nothing but what? Omega CR. Like that, second one, parallel RL circuit, that is Q factor, which is nothing but what? Reactive power by real power. So, what is the reactive power for this? V square by X, XL, right? Like that, real power is what? V square by R. From this, we can get R by XL, which is equals to R by XL, which is equals to R by omega naught L, just reciprocal of that Q factor in case of series resonance. See, there we have what? Series combination of RC is nothing but what? 1 by omega CR. Here we have what? Omega CR. Like that, Q factor of R, parallel combination of RL is nothing but what? R by omega, sorry, this is not omega naught, only omega L. R by omega L, there we have what? Omega L by R. So, like that, R, L and C, R, L, C. For this, Q factor is nothing but we can write, now we have to write resonant frequency into C R, which is equals to R by resonant frequency into L. This is the Q factor for this, okay. And next, fourth one, this is different case, that is parallel combination of L and C. This is LC. For this, Q net, Q factor is Q1 or QL1, quality factor of L plus quality factor of C. That's it. Next, we know that IL is equals to what? IL is equals to what? V by XL, right? Which is equals to source current into resistance into XL. Therefore, IS into R by XL is nothing but what? Omega R into L, right? From this, IL is equals to what? I into R by omega R into L, which is equals to I into R by omega R into L is nothing but what? Q factor, right? So, from this, Q factor is equals to what? IL by I. This is first one. Like that, second, IC, which is equals to V by XC, source current into resistance. XC is nothing but what? 1 by omega C. We can write, okay, wait. IS into R by XC. Therefore, IC is equals to IS into R by XC is nothing but what? We can write omega R into C. Therefore, which is nothing but what? Q factor. So, IC is equals to source current into Q factor for parallel RC circuit or parallel RLC. Here we are considering resonant frequency into L, resonant frequency into C. Therefore, Q factor, which is equals to IC by IS. From
1 and 2
quality factor for resonant circuit is nothing but IL by I, simply IC by IS, okay, or source current, both are equal. So under parallel resonance condition, this Q factor is called as C, current magnification factor. Under is called as current magnification factor. There in series RLC circuit, Q is equal to what? VL by V, which is equal to VC by V, voltage magnification factor. Here we have what? Current magnification means what? See, the current through inductor is Q times of source current. Like that, the current through capacitor is Q times of source current magnified, right? Current magnified. Like that, in case of series RLC, voltage is magnified. That is why Q factor is also called as current as well as voltage magnification factor. Next, we will discuss bandwidth. See, under resonance, Y is equals to what? 1 by R, right? Y is equals to 1 by R, like that, at or you can write this is what? At resonant frequency it is 1 by R, like that, at half power frequencies, what is the value of Y? Which is equal to root 2 by R. In case of series RLC circuit, at resonant frequency we have what? Z is equal to R. At half power frequency we are having Z is equal to root 2 R, right? Like that, we have admittance is equal to root 2 by R, that is it, root 2 into this part, that is it. So this is the frequency. What is the, this is the admittance graph, right? Yeah. Or you can current, because with respect to current only you can write. This is what? 1 by R. Then this is the maximum value of current, or right, this is lower cutoff frequency, this is resonant frequency, this is higher cutoff frequency, okay. So whatever may be the value at this point, for example, infinite value of current we have, but we have what? 0.707 value of current we have to consider, right? This is the criteria to select the bandwidth, that's it. At omega is equal to 0, we have maximum value of current, that is infinite value of current. We don't need that current, just to only we need I by root 2 times of area, right? That from here to here. That's it. That is Y is equals to root 2 by R. Therefore, Y is equals to what? 1 by R whole square plus omega c minus 1 by omega l whole square, which is equals to root 2 by R. Therefore, 1 by R whole square 2 by R square. From this, omega c minus 1 by omega l whole square, 2 by R square minus 1 by R square, finally we got 1 by R square, right? Therefore, we have two cases, K case 1, case 2. What is case 1? Omega C minus 1 by omega L, which is equals to plus 1 by R. Case 2 is what? Omega C minus 1 by omega L, which is equals to minus 1 by R. So, from 1 and 2, we got the upper cutoff frequency is equals to 1 by 2 CR integral 1 by 2 CR whole square plus 1 by LC. Like that, lower cutoff frequency minus 1 by 2 CR plus 1 by LC. This is the value of upper cutoff frequency, the value of lower cutoff frequency. From this, we can get resonant frequency is equals to, this is also satisfied, right? Sorry, here we have what? Plus, right? This is A plus B, A minus B, C. A square 1 by 2 CR whole square plus 1 by LC minus 1 by 2 CR whole square. So, this one gets cancelled. Finally, we have what? 1 by LC. Square root of 1 by LC we got. That is, at any case, the relation between resonant frequency and half power frequency is nothing but what? Geometrical mean of half power frequencies. Okay? Already we have derived this upper cutoff frequency and lower cutoff frequency in case of series RLC. Okay. Next, we know that Q factor is equals to what? Omega R C R. From this, Q factor by resonant frequency is nothing but C R. Sorry, first we have to calculate the bandwidth, right? From this, bandwidth is equals to what? Upper cutoff frequency minus lower cutoff frequency. Upper cutoff frequency is what? 1 by 2 CR. This one gets cancelled. We can get 1 by 2 CR plus 1 by 2 CR, which is equals to 2 by 2 CR. 2 gets cancelled. Therefore, bandwidth is equals to 1 by CR. In terms of radians per second, or f in terms of bandwidth is equals to 1 by 2 pi RC heads, 1 by 2 pi RC. In case of series RLC circuit, we have what? R by L. Here we have what? 1 by RC. There we have what? R by 2 pi L. Here we have 1 by 2 pi RC heads. So, from this, bandwidth is what? 1 by CR. So, from this, resonant frequency by Q factor is equals to what? 1 by CR, which is equals to what? Bandwidth. Is there any change in the value of relation? Obviously, at any case, bandwidth is equals to, or Q factor is equals to, resonant frequency by bandwidth. Same like in the case of series RLC circuit. What is the relation? Q factor is always inversely proportional with bandwidth. So, these are the important observations from this two resonance circuits. That's it.